A controller action return type can be an object or an array or a value type like integer or double. And when we have a return type like this, if we go to the Swagger documentation, what we will see that the object type return comes as a part of the schema. The Swagger documentation automatically understands what is the return type and it provides the entire schema. And if we expand here also, in the example of 200 success, it's going to show how the return type is going to be. And we can try it out and we can see the response. Now, the problem with this return type is that, let's say for example, based on a condition, we want to return a bad request or a 404. In that case, how it going to work? So here, if we just want to return, let's say if we have a simple condition, if false, and this is not an appropriate example, but just for the purpose of demonstration, let's say if else condition and if is just false. And here we want to return bad request, for example. You'll see that this is not working because it is going to say that, you know, it cannot convert bad request to an IEnumerable of weather forecast. And this is where we can use an I action result or action result as return type. Now, there is a subtle difference between I action result and action result, which is something that we are going to discuss later. But as you can understand, when multiple return types are possible as a part of a web API, that is when we have to use either I action result or action result as return type. So here, if we change this IEnumerable of weather forecast to I action result, and now at this point, you see that the red squiggly is gone and there is no more error. And now, if we change it to I action result, what we also have to do is here, the return type has to be one of the action result implementation. And in this case, it is going to be OK, because we want to return a OK response for this case. And now, if we run this application, we can see that there is no more error. And once the Swagger documentation shows up, we will be able to execute this function as expected. But there is a problem with this now. Earlier, if you remember, we were able to see the schema of the return, but the schema is missing now. Even when we expand, we just see 200 success, but we don't know what is the schema. So if we execute, here it is coming at bad request, but if we go and change this to true and restart, still, we will not be able to see the schema either outside in Swagger or when we expand the Swagger method. And as you can see, it is missing the schema here as well as here. And if we execute, we can see the response working as expected. To fix the problem of schema, what we can do is we can use an attribute which is called produces response type. So produces response type can take a couple of parameters. So it can take a status code and properties and type. And then the second overload takes a type and status code. So this is the one we are going to use. So for the type, we can say type of weather forecast array, because that's our type. And for the status code, we can say status codes dot, and status codes has bunch of constant. And for us, one of the status codes is 200. And we also have another status code of 400. So we can get rid of these because during 400, we do not return any type. And we can say status code of 400 bad request. Now, if we restart this application, what is going to happen is even with action result, we are going to see the schema showing up in Swagger documentation. So here you can see the Swagger documentation has the schema again, just like before, as well as here the schema is showing up. And if we execute, it is going to work as expected, which is that it is going to return the expected response. And you can see it is returning the response as expected. Now, this is the gist of how iActionResult works. And for action results, what we can do, action result is a generic type. And for the action result here, we can pass weather forecast array as the type. And in that case, the subtle difference is we do not need the type of parameter provided to the producer's response type anymore, because this has the type defined here. And everything else is going to remain the same. The other subtle difference between iActionResult and ActionResult is ActionResult is more type safe because it is specifying exactly what type it is going to return. So now if I run this application, I'm going to see exact same behavior as before, meaning the type information is going to show up in the documentation of Swagger as schema as expected, as well as when we expand. And if we try it out, we're going to see expected response. Now, there are a couple of other things that I wanted to share, is that apart from bad request, we can also have things like not found. And all of these, the bad request or not found, they have, if we look into the overload, they have an overload which where we can provide an object, just like okay, which takes an object. Similarly, bad request, for bad request, it takes something like model state dictionary, and model state dictionary is containing the errors to be returned to client. And the third one is just the object error. The other thing we can use apart from okay, bad request, and not found is created. Created is a create result object that produces status code of 201. So created should only be used with an HTTP post, because we should not be creating any resources through HTTP GET. Only through HTTP post we should be creating an object. And if we use the created, then it is going to return a 201. So if I have to do a demo here, again, we should never ever use created with get. It should always be used with post. But just for the convenience of this demo, I am using created here. So we can use created. Now created takes two parameters. It has a string URI and the object. URI is essentially which URI can be used after it's been created for returning the object. That's a standard HTTP post implementation for creating. And it also can take an URI, either string URL or URI. So here we can just give a dummy URL. And here let's change the status code to 201 created, and let's restart, just to demonstrate how created is going to work. And here now in the documentation, we can see the response type is created and it is a status code of 201. And if we execute this, we can see the expected response of the array and the status code being 201. So that is all I wanted to cover for today's video. The main goal of this video was to show when to use an iActionResult or ActionResult of T. And the main use case for that is when multiple return types are possible for a single method. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you are new to my channel and you think you are getting value out of my channel, please subscribe to my channel. And thanks so much for watching this video.